Whoa, what a weird dream. I'm sure it has absolutely nothing to do with today's video. Anyway, hey, I am Jelle, and last weekend I joined Ludum Dare, a 72-hour game jam, together with Ollie from Mashup Games. As always, the team was announced in the middle of the night. So, I got up bright and early and checked out this year's team, stuck in a loop. Time to write down some ideas while I wait for Ollie to wake up. When I got around 8 different ideas or so, Ollie and I got together and started discussing. I was just plotching out my ideas, from time travel to hula hoops to sumo wrestling. There was no way we weren't going to choose any of my teams. But from the moment Ollie said trains, I was sold. We were going to make a train game. Ollie was going to do the coding part, so I could spend my time on the visuals. I started with the most important thingy, the train. I went for an old school cartoon train with a big engine and giant rear wheels, 2 pistons on the side to push the train forwards, and a bright front light. And to top things off, a chimney. It was a bit past noon, and just like the train, I needed to let off some steam. And what better way to do that than with some VR gaming? Pew pew, pew pew, pew pew, pew pew, pew. Alright, back to work. The next thing on the list, after the train, was a thing that comes after the train. The carriages. I made them in the same style, quick and easy. It's a game jam after all. A coal carriage to fuel our little train, and a person carriage for our passengers. With the train done, and Ollie happy, I got started on the tracks. Ollie already wrote some code to make the tracks work, and made some temporary boxes in the correct shape. So, I had my work cut out. I wanted to make the tracks fit together nicely, but I also wanted to keep them symmetrical. So, I couldn't use the normal in and out puzzle parts. Luckily, I had a big brain moment, and noticed that if you put both sides next to each other, you can rotate the tracks, and they'll still fit together. This was perfect for the corners. Now, I only had to make one type that could go both left and right. So, the train can now go places, but there is nowhere to go. Where are the passengers going to wait for their train? Well, at a station, of course. I made sure they would be instantly recognizable and gave it a big bright roof. So, it's clear what color of station it will be. That will be important in the future. After a whole bunch of modeling, I wanted to do something different for the remainder of the evening. I hopped into Unity and saw that Ollie had been a very busy man. There was a functional railway system, and you could place tracks wherever you wanted on the table. And once you made a nice loop, the train would go all around. When I was done admiring and playing with the tracks, I gave the train some life, with the help of some animations and particle effects. I programmed the piston shaft to follow the wheel and stick in the piston. I also added some smoke particles when the train is riding along. We finished day one with a quick call to plan out the gameplay mechanics, what the player would have to do to win, and how they could achieve that, and got to bed. Ah, what? You want to know how the game is going to work? Well, let me explain. So, you're in control of a little train, and it's your job to get the passengers to their destination. You do this by building your track so it passes all the stations and start carrying the passengers around. And you should do it as fast as possible, because no one likes trains that run late. But you have to be careful not to hit any obstacles along the way, or you'll be responsible for a huge crash. So, Ollie and I both knew what to do and got to work. I did some more modeling, of course. I made a car crossing piece to give the train a place to cross the road, and made some cute gates that go up and down. Duh. Speaking of crossings, I also made a track piece that moves the train up so it can go higher and cross things it normally can't. I was on a roll. I kept pumping out track pieces. I made a splitter track with an arrow and a switch track piece to make clear what direction you would go to, and I also made a single leg piece, and I made a U-turn, and I made more pieces, and I made more pieces, and maybe I went a little bit overboard with the track pieces. I'm just giving Ollie more work with him having to implement all those different things. You know what? Why don't I do something useful for the rest of the day and set up the car system? I made those crossings for a reason, alright? We needed a system that allows us to quickly place a road on the table and have the cars follow it nicely. Luckily, I have just a thing. In my last game jam, I made a caravan chasing game with a procedural road, where the road is drawn as a spline, and I use an image to follow that spline. That way, you get a smooth road. I can just do the same thing here and draw a quick road texture. Make a cute toy car with some toy wheels and a winder to get the car going. And after a little bit of coding, I can create a road with a spline and put some cars on there, and they'll follow the points on the roads, all nicely behind each other, so they won't crash into each other. Oh, well, if they're far enough, of course, the points aren't exactly spaced equally. Game jam! I set up the car crossing track too, but kind of in the opposite way. Instead of the cars having to wait for the train, I made the train wait for the cars. This way, you would have to time your start right, so you won't have to wait at all. And with that done, it was time for a good night's rest, and wake up at a nice hour. Psych! I got up with the sun and started working on the game. Today was the final day, and we didn't even have the core gameplay loop yet. So, Ollie got to fixing the tracks and the passenger system, while I started to flesh out the game. I made some more 3D models of random office stuff and giant backdrop, and I got started on the start and end screen. I sprinkled some objects around and added a button. And you know, good enough for a game jam. Just like the end screen. Change up the camera a bit, and ta-da, a completely different scene. Now, onto the important stuff, the levels. We didn't want to use a boring old tutorial screen to explain the rules, so I incorporated the how to play into the scene by making it look like it's written on the table. 1. Drag the track. 2. Rotate the track. 3. Put it in the right spot, and choo-choo, off we go. While Ollie was still finishing the passenger system, I got to work on some more obstacles. Right now, we only have a road, so we wanted to add some more. But something that wouldn't take a lot of time. Oh, what about a river? You might be thinking, what? Adding a whole water system is so complicated. Oh man, you have no idea. I worked tirelessly on a super complex water system with fluid simulations and erosion and... Oh yeah, that works as well, I guess. Good job, me. The hours were passing by, and I made another tutorial level to explain how to pick up the passengers. And while Ollie was laying out the final touches on the programming, I made a quick little song at the speed of sound. Took some loops, threw on a piano, and called it done. Because we only had a couple of hours left, and we still only had 2 levels, I put on my headphones, put on some 80s motivational music, and began the level design speedrun. We had to be done by midnight, and I have never felt so alive. We were adding stuff like there was no tomorrow. Boom, another level. Here, some sound effects. Whoa. Wiggling passengers. 3, 2, 1, and the time is up. We put it on itch.io and made the game page on the Ludum Dare site and called it a night. Right on time. Do you hate your boring office job? Tired of everyone always being mad because a train is being delayed? Well, we have just a thing for you. Train troubles. Hang up your real conductor's head and pick up a virtual one. Put a track on the table and watch the train go by. Can you bring all the passengers to their correct station? Test it now on yalever.h.io/train-troubles. Pleasure guaranteed. Pleasure not actually guaranteed. You're not responsible if you quit your job to play this game. Toy trains sold separately. If you like this video, then be sure to check out Ollie's perspective. He did an amazing job with the programming, and the game wouldn't have worked at all if it weren't for him. So, check it out in the links everywhere. Oh, and like and subscribe to see more games like this in the future. And I'll see you guys next time for another exciting episode of Yelle makes something and then immediately regrets making it and putting it on the internet. Bye!